Hi everybody, welcome back. Let's talk about 12 content ideas that can help you build an audience. So everyone out there knows that content marketing is one of the best forms of marketing out there these days. But developing content on a regular basis is really hard. You have to come up with a lot of great ideas that are magnetic, that are going to add value to people's lives and businesses. And coming up with those ideas on a regular basis can be a struggle. And I get a lot of comments and questions from people about how to develop content, what they can do content about. So I wanted to share with you 12 ideas for developing fresh content that can help you build your audience. First of all, number one, case studies. Do a case study on a company or an entrepreneur or a business about what they're doing well, about what they're doing poorly. You can do comparisons. You can take two different companies and kind of pro-con them against each other in your content. Who's doing something new? Who's being innovative? Make sure that you're injecting your point of view, your opinion about what you're talking about in the case study. Number two, teach something. Education is one of the best forms of content. Share strategies and processes in your industries with others. Share things like, you know, for designers, it could be like how to develop a creative brief or how to do a mood board or how to plan a project or how to put together a presentation. You could talk about roles. So in design, it might be, you know, what does a creative director do? What does a design director do? What does a junior designer do? What does a marketing person do? Sharing that kind of information with your audience can be really valuable. You could talk about tools, you can talk about applications, you can talk about software, you can talk about methods or secrets in your industry. All of those things can be very educational and make for really great content. Number three is reporting. It's reporting back on things that you've done or events you've gone to or conferences that you've gone to or speakers that you've heard. It's commenting and reporting back on industry news, on hot topics in your industry. So acting like a reporter, put on a reporter's hat and think about your content that way. Number four is interviews. Interviews are probably one of the most prevalent formats of content for podcasts, but you can also do interviews in written form or in video. You can send out a list of questions to someone you want to interview and get written responses and publish those as content. You could also pose a single question to a range of experts and take in all of the responses and publish that as content. Also, one-on-one interviews are really helpful. You could take particular roles in your industry or industries that relate or react or are involved or cross-pollinate with your industry and interview those people. So interviews are a great form of content. Number five is business management. So you can do content around business processes in your industry. So you could talk about things like organizational processes or management processes or project management processes, time management. You could talk about things like resources or services that you use in the running of your business. You could talk about pricing or quoting or pitching, those all sorts of process aspects of a business that you can share about and make into content. Number six is marketing topics. How people market in particular industries sometimes are different from each other. So how are people marketing in your industry? What is working in your industry? What is not working? What are the social platforms that people are using? What are the different approaches on social that people are using? How are they advertising? What kind of content are they developing? Where do they market? Is it digital? Is it physical? Talking about marketing tips in your realm, your category, your industry can be a great theme for content. Number seven is business development topics. So everyone wants to get more business. Everyone wants to get more clients. So you can share in your content, be transparent in your business and talk about what's working for you, what's not working for you, what's a challenge. You can also look outside of your business and talk about your industry in general. Look at the leaders, look at the laggers, talk about what they're doing in terms of business development. Use it as a theme for content. Number eight is trends in your industry. You can talk about things that are new in your industry, that are new and exciting and innovative and inspiring. You can talk about what's old and what's kind of tired in your industry. You can talk about who are the innovators in your industry, who are the laggards in your industry. You can also talk about trends in materials or trends in resources, trends in marketing, trends in strategies, trends in tactics. All of these make for great ideas. Number nine is reviews. Reviews are a tried and true way of developing content. You can review things like books or websites or events or conferences or digital products, things like services or software as a service or apps. But when you review, you'll also want to make sure that you're bringing to it your particular perspective, because that's what's going to establish you as an expert and elevate you in your field. You want to have a point of view about what it is that you're reviewing. Number 10 is inspiration. What is inspiring you in your industry, in your category? You want to talk about what's happening in your industry. What is it that's, you know, sparking your interest? What is it driving your work? What's driving your creativity? What's driving your innovation? Talk about inspiration and share that inspiration with others so they can be inspired too. Number 11 is infographics. Infographics are a really great way to develop content. Now, everyone out there might not have the skills, the design skills, the organizational skills to create infographics themselves, but there are a lot of companies out there that develop infographics from your content or from your ideas, and they'll do it for you, and a lot of times the cost is really manageable. So you can develop infographics around things like processes in your industry or trends or news or statistics or data in your industry, the best of your industry, the worst of your industry. So infographics are unique and not very prevalent form of creating content, but they're very sticky, meaning people love to forward and share infographics with each other. And they seem to go around and around. And so you can get a lot of traction when you take the time and make the investment into developing an infographic. And finally, number 12 is Q&A. What you want to do essentially is you want to pose a question and then answer it. Now you can get questions from your followers, your subscribers, people who comment in the comment section. You can use questions that you've heard elsewhere and pose the question and then answer it. Question and answer type of content is really magnetic because a lot of times the questions that's being asked are, you know, pretty popular, and a lot of people have that question, and it makes people curious when they read that question in the subject heading to find out the answer. So Q&A is a really great topic and way to pose and structure content. So that's it. I hope you liked this video on 12 fresh ideas for developing content. And if you did, please hit subscribe below so you can see my videos when they come out. And make sure to hit that notifications bell so you can get alerted when I post a new video or when I go live. Visit me at philipvandusen.com. If you need help with your brand strategy, your brand design, or your professional creative career, reach out to me and let's see what we can do to take you to the next level. And with that, thanks again for watching. I really, really appreciate it. And bye for now.